drivers. Now, as I was saying before, I had to fix all my sound because computers are terrible and awful things. I hate them, but they're the only way to play. They're the only way to play video. Anyways, we are in Faultline, and we are about to begin the Agent G arc. Last time, we discovered that Arachnus was searching for something in Faultline, as were these Sky Readers. Greetings, Guns and Roses. I'm Agent G. I'm glad you came. We first discovered that Arachnus was operating Faultline when it became apparent something had driven out the Circle of Thorns. At first, we thought they were here to raid old hero bases just like the Sky Raiders. However, unlike the Sky Raiders, we soon noticed that their salvage operations were cover for a directed search. At first, we thought they might be attempting to recover Faultline's earthquake machines, but with what I've learned following your work with Dr. Delilah Stein, I fear it's much worse. I believe that Arachnus is close to locating the Psycho Chronometron. I've done as much as I can covertly to stop them, now I need it. Over a partner to finish the operation. A Faultline in the Sands of Time, Part 1. We must know how Arachnus has learned before we even know where to begin. How much Arachnus has learned before we even know where to begin. But your first mission will be intelligence gathering. The Sky Raiders have recently captured several Arachnus codes. They've hidden the codes in several laptops while they attempt to crack them for security. They've stashed this operation in their own backyard, thinking that we don't know. They can use us for protection in our own backyard. If you are not a known Longbow agent, you could break up their operation and still leave them thinking that Longbow doesn't know what they're up to. Oh, hello there. The Wing Raider with the Quantum Gun. There must be a War Shader Teespring around. Sky Raiders have some guts setting up shop just this close to a long way. is chatter from the Sky Raiders about how they rigged one of their assault songs. Glowy. I was like, this is bad. Arachnos changes the codes they need to access their bases and computers frequently. Fortunately, these codes should still be good for a little while. Thank you. I mean, next time I'll learn not to open a door when I'm Elvis. It's gonna be a long trip. Thank you.
Okay.
Cascading defense failure on my side, I guess. Oh.
Excellent work. This information will prepare for the next phase of the operation. It is vitally important we learn a closer diagnosis to finding the Psycho Criminal. Personally, I'm worried that they might be much closer to finding than we need to. You've done well. I think we'll be able to work together. With the codes you've recovered from the Sky Raiders, we can now access the Arrakis. There should be a great deal of information there, and tell us your first teleport to Arrakis is not to finding the Psycho Critter. However, to do that, you need to enter an Arrakis base and access their mission is going to send you deep into the Arrakis controlled area's fault line. Stolen codes of you'll obtain to infiltrate their base and ascertain just how much information Arrakis has recovered about the Psychochronomatron or PCM device. Actual contact with the enemy is not necessary, but you can some confusion in the ranks, so it's a viable option. Fortunately, we have the equipment to issue to you for this task. We've recently captured several Arrakis uniforms with their identity transponders and will only work for about an hour, but that should be enough. And I give you this cool willpower that turns you into a full spider. Send you to the far, far part of the zone.
Oh, jeez. Okay. This is that sort of mission. And the agents are discussing the relationship between Sans and Nocturne. Nocturne's names. You found this document on the Arachnos network you infiltrated. It appears to be an undeleted journal file from Nocturne the Night Widow. I never would have come if I'd known Sans was in charge here. This may be by chance. Many of the troops here are unsure of his leadership, though none dare to speak against an arbiter. This Gizmo's after is real, then. Be ashamed to actually let him have it. Not when I can think of some much better use. Greater relationships. At this point, the forward base is recently established. Troop strength was assigned to transporting goods. During this first attempt to establish a range base between our forward and supply race that our first real Sky Raider attacks occurred. In retrospect, their previous attacks must have been to probe our defenses. Now that they knew how carefully we shepherd our resources, the constant raid. Date, our forward base still has no connection to our support base, while the Sky Raiders are making a fortune selling our weapons. Arbiter. You found a document from on the Arachnos that network you infiltrated. This one looks like a progress report. My Lord Recluse, I've narrowed down the final resting place of the Psychochronometron with three possible. I expect to have the device in it. Back in back. Attached are the personnel and material, our operational retirements, material and personnel. There are some plans attached. This right knowledge and information would be able to track down the three possible sites for you. Oh, here. Sins, I read your report about the fault line incident. Our unusual interpretation. Really, spoken with Arbiter Deos. Yes,
based on recommendation I only your operation in Paragulfs. You are correct about this psychochronometron. I must have it for the greater glory of Arachne. This is excellent information, but looks like we may already be too late. According to Arbiter Sam's reports, they've narrowed the PCM final location down to sites. We cannot allow them to recover that device. I have been cleared to present you with a report containing a variety of worst-case scenarios should Arachne use the device. Study it. I want you to know what you're fighting against. You've located the three sites where Arachnos believes Psychochronometron may have come to rest. All three sites are close to the forward Arachnos base. We need to investigate those locations. The PCM might have ended up anywhere during the chaos of the following year. Seems too coincidental it would end so close to Arachnos. Confidentially, I hope they've almost fooled us and wait to see how much we... I don't think that's likely. Concern yourself with investigating the bases and bury the Arachnos. Make all Arachnos troops tend to each day to disrupt further excavations. So we need to clear out a bunch of ruins. That's so they don't bear in. Always. Say I did this. This was one of like the first real story arcs I did in the game. the whole zone.
I remember the first time I did this. I got lost in those tunnels really, really bad. It took me like an hour to find the first mission because I just didn't understand that. There was a giant underground area.
I love how the Arachnos robots get to be, smarmy.
That's not too great.
up and shooting him instead of shooting him way back there. guess I have to clear all the rat motion too. Alright, that's fine.
Endurance problems for the past mission or so. And that last excavation, we found tattered shreds of a costume from Psycurse. So Arachnos found the PCF before. This is the mission I thought was. Okay. So the Sky Raiders are.
And Night Widows do not screw around. Okay. The one last mission. Got thrown by ice arrow. Oh, Rachno, sure.
was without missing that as arrow. What? No. You reset. You were 100% reset. They would have sucked. Oh, there she is. Oh, come on. Really? Still alive. Of course she is. Thank you.
Creek and Nightwood.
Oh, there you are.
I'm landed. You can wear off any time now. There we go. The real thing is to imagine doing that on something that's not a mastermind. At least the pets can ignore the, stupid. Come on.
Well, that's... I am glad you came by to watch me get my rear end kicked by Arachnos lieutenants, because I can't mess them. Or against minions, too, because I apparently can't hit for crap today. All over. Arachnos wouldn't be so bad on this character if the downgrade the bosses that were downgraded has the extra layer of defense protection. If not for that, I don't think it'd be too bad. The only thing that'd be real iffy is the Night Widows. They have the stupid frickin' blind grenades. And they hit like trucks. I am actually somewhat surprised we haven't seen any of the Arachnos clockwork. I mean, it's sensible that they wouldn't show up in this mission because this predates Praetoria stuff. But they, I don't generally have a whole lot of problem with Mu Adepts. Being Trick Arrow, Ice Arrow is a really big deal. It lets me like completely eliminate a mob from the fight. So, like being able to knock down the strongest enemy in the fight usually. And eliminate the minions around it, or taking the big mobs on by themselves. Makes those things more capable of. A bit easier to handle. A lot of these Arachnos mobs. Oh, that's when you just drag the entire group over to where the Mu guy is. Yep, that's down here, boss. PCM won't be in here. A note in the vault. Oh, okay. This vault was supposed to hold the psychochronometron, but instead only had this note. Nocturne. Have some sense, my dear. I learned a long time before never to trust a Night Widow. I will take the psychochronometron to Lord Recluse personally, no hard feelings, I hope. Arbiter Sands. It's a shame that Nocturne never showed up again. Actually makes me wonder if Sands had her executed for screwing with his plans, given that he's an Arbiter. Well, I know this looks bad, but it's not over yet. I've been in communications with two other agents codenamed Indigo and Crimson. Ooh, they're actually important names that show up later. They believe that Sens has not yet left Paragon City. There may still be time to stop him before he can deliver the PCM to his masters. I have a plan. Arbiter Sens is still in Fallline, probably trying to avoid detection till he can escape to the Rogue Isles. The psychochronometron requires psychic powers to activate, and Arbiter Sens has none. However, he does have a rival who has access to psychic powers.
is antagonistic to sense. That's a weird sentence. And may know how and when he plans to escape Paragon City. Nocturne Night Widow. The plan is to lure Nocturne into a trap and get information from her. We know that Arbiter Sands and the Night Widow Nocturne are enemies. From what we know of the internal structure of Arachnos, this isn't an uncommon situation and we can turn it to our advantage. I will plant false information that Longbow has potential blackmail material against Sands hidden in our base in the dam. She takes the bait, we catch her and find out about Arbiter Sands' most likely escape routes and times. Your job is to catch her in the dam. It's a long shot, but it's all we have. Now we fight Nocturne again. It's quiet now, but once the trap is sprung, fireworks will begin. Hopefully this fight goes as well as the last Nocturne fight did. Now my minions, search this place. With Longbow's files on Arbiter Sands, I will be able to break him and claim the Psychochronometron for my own. And they realize it's a trap. There is an Arachnos minion called Jenkins, because this game loves its references. Oh, hi, Operative Jenkins.
That was either Drim blowing up or my, or Duff using his, flash weapons. Hard to tell sometimes. That must have been, flash weapons going on. Don't really need to clear everything here, however. I am close to leveling and apparently didn't get there. Oh hey, so that would help. Thing is, Nocturne's not even the worst enemy type in terms of being a assassin that Arachnus has. There is a sidekick of one of the four Arachnus lieutenants called Silver Mantis. She is obscenely tough, given her position in the game. Is a mission that was that never made it live, but you can play here, where you fight her at the end, and she will shred you apart if you're not, like, high level. You fight her with, like, three NPC allies, and she can conceivably just one-shot any of them at will. Silver Mantis is not a joke. I'll have more trouble fighting her on my proper character than I do the actual head quote unquote headline stalker Mako has a bunch of goofy non-stalkery attacks where Doramantis just gets the full spine set. Oh. Are we showing your previous frequency, please? glad she didn't aggro there. That would have been really crappy. Run up to her. I'm gonna die. That was gonna hurt. Oh, missed. Gosh. I'd have survived that if the medic had healed me right when he came out. I don't think his heal is part of the upgrade. No. At least she doesn't have the... Pardon me. At least she doesn't have the smoke grenades. AV class villain with smoke grenades? Ew, that'd be terrible. Alright, where'd you run off to? You're hidden. There you are. I should have waited until I had my pets recharged to start that fight. I was hoping to prevent her from regenerating too much. Across the zone. Oh no, okay. He's right up there.
Outline in the Sands of Time, Part 4. Done excellent work today, Guns N' Roses. Nocturne is on her way to Zagursky, but I learned what we needed to know from her. I told her that Sen sold her out to keep her from messing with his plans, and she was more than willing to talk to get back at him. She was able to tell us how and when Sen's plans to escape, but she also told us that she gave that information to someone else in an attempt to delay Sen's, Captain Castillo of the Sky Raiders. We now know how, when, and where Sans is planning to escape with the PCM, but Nocturne also told Captain Castillo. I don't think Castillo really knows what the Psychochronometron does, just that it's valuable. He is certain to try and get it. I think the best option is a preemptive strike to stop him. But this is where we will end it for today. It is 8 o'clock and I need to get something to eat. Thank you everybody who came by to watch. Anybody who is watching this on YouTube, thank you for coming by. And here's another... Wing Raider with a quantum gun, huh. But... anyways, if you're watching this on YouTube, like, subscribe, all that, you can come watch live around 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Thursdays. Good hunting, and have a good week, everybody.